Discussing about the electric dipole, fourth concept in the first chapter we are discussing. What is meant by dipole? What is meant by dipole moment? What is the electric field intensity on the axial line of the dipole, on the equatorial line of the dipole we discussed. So for example, if this is the dipole, here a charge minus Q is there, here a charge plus Q is there, then it will be called as the dipole. So on the axial line, what is the field intensity means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube. If the dipole is short, we are using the formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube, if r is the distance of that point. If we consider the point on the equatorial line, then what is the field intensity means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p by r cube. Yesterday we discussed this one. Now if the point is not on the axial line, not on the equatorial line, what formula we will use to find the electric field intensity? Let us see. Point is not on the axial line, it is not on the equatorial line. So this is the dipole. This is the center of the dipole. At this point, the line joining the point and center of the dipole is making an angle theta with the center of the dipole, with the axis of the dipole. So with the axis of the dipole, the line joining the point and center of dipole making an angle theta, then what is the field intensity at that point? Understanding the concept? So here what we have to do, we know dipole moment is a vector quantity. We can resolve the dipole moment in two components. Actually, dipole moment will be in this direction. Dipole moment is from minus Q to plus Q. If we resolve the dipole moment into two components, this component of P will be equal to P cos theta, and perpendicular component will be P sin theta. So if we resolve this dipole moment into two components, one will be P cos theta, another will be P sin theta. Means how to consider this P cos theta is there, na? So there is a dipole, half dipole moment P cos theta. Then the given point will comes on the axial line of the dipole. On the same line it is there, na? So it will comes on the axial line. So E parallel component we will call that as, that's value because of that parallel component, 2P cos theta by r cube. This distance is r only. Is my point is clear? Dipole moment I am resolving into two components. One will be P cos theta, another one will be P sin theta. So the given point in the same direction of P cos theta means on the axial line of the dipole that point is there. If a dipole, half dipole moment P cos theta is there, then that point will comes on the axial line of that dipole. Then 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p cos theta by r cube. Same point, this is also one more dipole having dipole moment p sin theta. This one, this point will comes on the equatorial line of this dipole. On the equatorial line, what is the formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p by r cube. Here that dipole moment is P sin theta, so this value 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P sin theta by r cube. This point, if we assume a dipole like this, then that point will comes on the equatorial line of that dipole. Therefore, on the equatorial line, this is the formula. These two, so it will create the field in this direction. E parallel. This will create the field in this direction. This will be E perpendicular. So net field there will be E is equal to square root of E parallel whole square plus E perpendicular square. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube, we can take common 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube. 2 cos theta whole square will be 4 cos square theta. Here sin theta, this value will be sin square theta. Cos square theta plus sin square theta value, 1 cos square theta, you divide this. So 3 cos square theta plus cos square theta plus sin square theta, cos square theta, sin square theta is 1. So finally this formula will becomes as E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube into square root of 3 cos square theta plus 1. This is the formula for electric field intensity at any point which is at a distance r from the center of the dipole. Try to understand, at least remember this formula. Point is on the axial line, theta value will be 0. Cos 0 is 1, so 3 plus 1 will be root 4, means 2. Formula on the axial line is coming. Are you understanding that? If the point is on the, this point came to here, then what will happen? E is equal to, point will comes on the axial line. Axial line formula already know, P by R cube. So 3 into 1 plus 1, cos 0 will be 1, so that's why cos 1 square means 1 only. So this value how much? 1 by 4 by epsilon naught 2 P by R cube. Same formula what is there for axial line, what we derived. From this also we will get the same formula. On the equatorial line means theta, you have to take it as 90. So cos 90 is 0. So this 3 cos square theta becomes 0. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube will come. So from this formula also, we can derive the electric field intensities on the axial line and on the equatorial line. Clear? Next. After finishing of this, one dipole is placed in the uniform electric field. Then torque will act on the dipole. What is the expression for torque acting on the dipole? Torque acting on the dipole placed in an uniform electric field. You know the formula already, derivation explained in the board. Tau value is equal to PE sin theta. Here P is what? Dipole's dipole moment. E is the electric field intensity. Theta will be the angle between E and P. Understanding? In vector form, how we will write this one? Tau bar is equal to P bar cross E bar. So if theta is equal to 0, means dipole is placed parallel to the field, then what will happen? There will no torque acts on the dipole. Tau value is equal to 0. If theta is equal to 90 degrees, means dipole is placed perpendicular to the electric field. Field is like this. I am keeping a dipole in this format. Then what will happen? Maximum torque will act on the dipole. And that maximum torque value will be tau is equal to PE. If we keep the dipole parallel to the field, anti-parallel to the field, always torque acting on that will be equal to 0. Means theta is equal to 0 degrees or theta is equal to 180 degrees. Torque on the dipole value will be equal to 0. Clear understanding? Theta is equal to 180 degrees. What is the torque on it? PE sine 180. Sine 180 value is also equal to 0. So tau value is equal to 0. Next. Work done to rotate the dipole. Work done to rotate the dipole in uniform electric field of intensity from an angle theta 1 to theta 2 is. So this is the field. One dipole is like this. It is making an angle theta 1 with the field. Now we rotate the dipole like this, such that this angle will be theta 2. So I moved the dipole in this direction. Initially, dipole is making an angle theta 1 with the field. After rotation, it is making an angle theta 2 with the field. Then what is the work done to rotate the dipole from an angle theta 1 to theta 2? Problems will be there. Then W is equal to PE into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This formula we can use. Work done to rotate the dipole. If the points are clear, then what is the potential energy of the dipole in the electric field? Work done to rotate the dipole from a position of maximum torque. When maximum torque will be there? When a dipole is making 90 degrees with the field, maximum torque will be there. From the maximum torque position, how much angle it is rotated to, that work done will be stored in the form of potential energy. So here theta 1 value will be 90 degrees. From this, it is rotated through an angle theta. So what will happen? U is equal to minus PE cos theta. This will be considered as the potential energy of the dipole. Work done to rotate the dipole from a position of maximum torque is stored as the potential energy of the dipole. Like this, questions will be there on this dipole. Last model will be there on the dipole. Let us see what is that last model. Are you writing, all of you? All these are the formulae. Write down, all of you. Next. Next, last will be, a dipole is placed in the uniform electric field. This is one electric field. There is a dipole like this. Then this dipole is slightly displaced from its equilibrium position. Already this dipole is in equilibrium. Slightly it is displaced from its equilibrium position. Then what is happening? This dipole will rotate like this, so it will oscillate in this format. Then what will be the time period of the dipole in the uniform electric field? So time period of dipole in uniform electric field. We kept the dipole in the uniform electric field. What will be its time period? Time period formula will be T is equal to 2 pi root of I by PE, where I is the moment of inertia of that dipole, P will be the dipole moment, E will be the field intensity. How this formula has came, let us see. Torque will act on the dipole when the dipole is slightly displaced through an angle theta. What is the torque acts on the dipole? This formula, how this is came? Torque on the dipole will be PE sine theta. Actually, this torque value again tries to bring back the dipole to its equilibrium position. That's why we will write minus here. Tau is equal to minus PE sine theta. This tau value will be equal to I alpha. So this is minus PE. Since theta value is small, we can write sin theta value as theta. So I alpha is equal to minus PE theta. Then alpha is equal to minus PE by I into theta. What is alpha here? Angular acceleration, dipole moment P, electric field intensity E, moment of inertia of the dipole. Theta is angular displacement. If we compare this with standard formula, minus alpha is equal to minus omega square theta. Here what we can say from this, alpha proportional to minus theta means angular acceleration directly proportional to angular displacement. So the oscillations of the dipole are in simple harmonic motion. They are in SH. Comparing with the standard formula, what we will get? Omega square is equal to PE by I. Then omega is equal to square root of PE by I. What is the formula for a time period? T is equal to 2 pi by omega. That is the formula. Then what we will get? T is equal to 2 pi by omega, 2 pi by root of PE by I. We will get this as T is equal to 2 pi square root of I by PE. So time period of the dipole in uniform electric field, T is equal to 2 pi square root of I by PE. The point is clear. These types of models will be there on the electric dipole. What are that? What is meant by dipole moment? Calculate the dipole moment. Like that, problems will be there. In the same manner, electric field intensity on the axial line of the dipole, on the equatorial line of the dipole, at any point from the dipole, torque acting on the dipole. Next, work done to rotate the dipole. Next, potential energy of the dipole. Next, time period of the dipole. Like that, different situations, different formulas will be there. You write the formula, learn the terminology. T is time period, I is moment of inertia, P is dipole moment, E is electric field intensity. In that format, you prepare the terminology, prepare the formula, direct questions will be there on that. Clear? Next, one more will be there. They will give the dipole like this. Bidipole. Here, one dipole is like this, bidipole, means combination of two dipoles. This angle will be theta, or this angle will be some 30 degrees. This dipole moment is P, this dipole moment is P. Find the net dipole moment of the system. Like that, problems will be there. This is nothing but, what will happen means that 2q I am separating, minus q, here already plus q, here already plus q, minus q, this angle will be 30 degrees. Let it be theta, general formula we will derive. This minus 2q, what I am doing, I am writing it as minus q and minus q. This is p, na? Dipole moment, this is P. We know dipole moment is a vector quantity. Then angle between, so two vectors, angle will be theta. Then what is the effective dipole moment? P dash is equal to square root of P square plus Q square 2PQ cos theta. Parallelogram law of vectors, R is equal to root of P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta, that formula we are applying here. So this value will be 2P square, this one, here also 2P square into 1 plus cos theta. P square plus P square will be 2P square plus 2P square cos theta, I took this one as common. Then cos theta, I am writing it as square root of 2p square 1 plus 2 cos square theta by 2 minus 1. Like that I am writing. 1 will cancel. Totally 4p square cos square theta by 2 will be there. Means p dash is equal to 2p cos theta by 2. So net dipole moment of the system P dash is equal to 2p cos theta by 2. Okay? On this model also, relating to dipole, problems will be there. Next. Last topic. Gauss law and its applications. Okay?